my name is Stephanie. I'm from Niles North High School. So as we were talking, we kind of thought about, like, wow, reading about such a horrible situation made us think about how a lot of us take our rights as Americans for granted and stuff. Do you believe that things or your situation have to get bad, like really bad, in order to evoke some sort of a response or in order to get better?
I think sometimes it helps. When you suffer, you can find meaning in the suffering, like I did and my cellmates did, is actually we thought, well, maybe this is an opportunity to grow in some ways, to become more patient or more calm, more understanding, more appreciative of our freedoms. But I don't think you have to go through that experience to appreciate freedoms. I mean, just reading about them and hearing about other stories and understanding what you have here and using your freedoms. You know, if you write a news article for your paper or write a weblog or just using Facebook, you know, these are all freedoms, and if you appreciate them, you don't have to go to jail to realize how important these freedoms are and that you can use these freedoms to help other people who can't speak out for themselves. Like, you can sign petitions, thank you. You can spread the word on Facebook. When I was in prison, people were doing parallel hunger strikes with me, and they were signing up on this free Roxana website, which some Northwestern students helped set up, actually. So all of these are ways to use your freedom to help people who don't have it, and then you learn to appreciate it that way.